In this video, I'm going to show you how to beat man-to-man coverage from the empty tray stack formation in the Pittsburgh Steelers playbook. What's going on, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If this is your first time visiting my channel focuses on helping people become the best Madden player they can possibly become. So if you're looking to get better at this game, I just want to encourage you to hit that subscribe button below. It's completely free to subscribe to the channel, and it just allows you to get access to all of our free tips. We release several videos every single day. So if you want to be up to date on all the latest tips for Madden 22, this is the best place to get all of that footage. Now, we're talking about the gun empty tray stack. This can be found in the Pittsburgh Steelers playbook. I did a previous video that explained kind of the packages of this scheme, but really I like to put the halfback stack package, then I like to sub in the receiver over here on this left side. And we went over that in a previous video, but we're gonna be just talking, you don't have to do that. I just think it works better, gets better personnel on the field, allows you to audible around. But we're gonna be talking about the play curl switch here in just a second. But before we do, if you wanna get this entire five wide receiver scheme, we talk about the empty tray stack, as well as the empty bunch, as well as the empty Y flex, you can get all of that stuff in our True Fan membership. So my True Fan membership is just $5 a month. And basically what it is, it's a great way for you to be able to support the channel and all the content that we do. And every single week you get a video that gives you an offensive meta update. So something new that I'm doing on the offensive side of the ball, might be a whole new scheme in the case of this last one. Or it might be something like a defensive tip. I do a defensive update every week. So the latest blitzes, the latest glitches, all of that stuff. And then I also break down a pro player every single week. So if you want to get access to that, the True Fan membership is down in the description. It's just $5 a month. Now let's talk about the play curl switch. Now I personally, this offense works really, really well in mutt because you can put abilities on your receivers that can help create separation against man-to-man coverage. In regs, you don't have to do the first setup, but I recommend it if you're in mutt. And all we're gonna do is we're just gonna put triangle here on a corner route. Now there's, again, there's two other things you can do. I have a tendency to just leave it like this and not do anything else. And the reason why is because if you get press man, you're just gonna throw this route right here to Mike Evans every single time. One of the beauties of the trace stack formation is that it's very consistent and very effective at beating man-to-man coverage, especially press man. For example, another thing that I could do is I could put Evans on a fade route. And what you'll see is that same thing happen. And basically, it'll give me a free release to the outside. So if I'm getting a lot of press man, that is an option that I have. So if you're in regs and you want to get kind of the same principle, then all you have to do is just put that back receiver on a fade route. Now, as far as the rest about man coverage, like what if they use her on that left side? Well, what I have is I have this really nice little snap throw right here to this drag route. That's probably my favorite route in the game right now because it gets in such a really unique position. It looks a little deeper than it really actually is. If you look at it, it looks a little bit more like a, almost like a crossing route. And it is a crossing route, but it really serves me well as a drag route. Look how he just drags across. And you can pretty much throw that at any point. If you're in mutt and you have a little bit better of a tight end in that position, that's gonna get even more separation for you. In regs, it still works. It's just you need to throw it a little bit sooner. The next route that I really like is this route to R1. Now you notice that I have a wide receiver there, and you'll see here, he just whips outside, beats man coverage every time. And as you can see, we can beat man coverage for about 30 yards on the sideline really, really easily. So you've got several ways that you can beat man-to-man coverage, especially press man, which is one of the, in my opinion, still hardest things to beat. The other thing about the square receiver is when he cuts over the middle of the field, he's going to beat man-to-man as well. So whether they press or not, it's not going to matter. That's going to get open every single time. Now, like I said, one of the things that I like to do is I like to put this, triangle receiver, if I can, if I have slot apprentice or hot route master, on our corner route. The reason I like the corner route is because let's say that they're not pressing. That corner route will beat man every single time if they don't press. If they don't press coverage, that's going to win. Now, you might be sitting there thinking to yourself, well, what do I do if I don't have hot route master? Well, what I would recommend you do that's going to cause essentially the same result is just leave him on his route or put him on a curl route. So I just put him on a simple curl route just like this. And what you'll see, if they're shading coverage up, I can lowball that every single time. And of course, Brady doesn't have gunslinger, so it kind of screwed me up a little bit. But typically that curl route is going to be there for you. I also threw that a little bit, just a little bit wonky. Let me show you that one more time. And you don't have to even curl him. You can just leave him on his curl. See how he goes to the outside? And he gets a little bit deeper on that, so I might just leave him on that. But that's going to get to the same kind of pocket of the field. These routes, one of the things that I've noticed about, especially this five wide scheme, is these routes get in different positions than what they look like on the screen. So it's not necessarily always going to look exactly like that. But anyways. And then lastly, the last route that I like against man coverage is this circle receiver. You're going to see that he is really a great route to just check down to. As you can see, just crosses against man. He's going to beat press man. He's going to beat off man. What I also like about that route is it's going to be very consistent for you if they run zone coverage. So if you get like a cover two or something, then everything sucks underneath, and then you got this nice delayed dig coming across formation. So all in all, this play is truly a money play. It's very good. It can beat every coverage as well. So it's not just man coverage that it can beat. It can also beat zone. Your reads are still the same. You're going to be looking left, and then you're going to be looking right, and you're going to be working the middle of the field. So I'm looking left, no, look right, no, and then I come back, and I can work the middle of the field against a Mabel coverage. Really what I love about this, too, is these routes all worked well together. AntCap24 from Hell.gg actually was working out of this formation earlier on in the season, and I have a lot of respect for him and the work he does over there. I think he's one of the best offensive minds in the community, and so just kind of listening to him and seeing how he's been doing out of five wide, this is a lot of fun. This is going to be a lot of fun for you, so shout out to AntCap for finding this incredible formation. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you want to get my version of the scheme and kind of my take on it, then you can get that in the True Fan member. Again, that's just $5 a month. It gets you pretty much all of my most up-to-date, in-depth stuff. So if you want to get access to that, that's available in the description. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to text me. My cell phone number is 208-218-6900.